guys. Today I'm going to show you how to disassemble and clean a Remington Versamax. So here we go. So first off, just going to make sure it's not loaded. Okay. Then I'm going to go ahead and take the barrel off. It's pretty easy, so just unscrew it. Grip off. Your barrel and piston assembly will just come off like that. Nothing to it. Set that there for now. Alright, now to disassemble, you can take this out. You're going to have to make sure push this down, because if it's not pushed down, your charging handle won't come off. So, sometimes kind of a pain in the butt. Got that, and this just slide out like so. Now you don't have to, but if you want to, you can take trigger assembly off. It's pretty simple. It's just one little right there. Pop that out. And your trigger assembly will just slide out like so. All right. Go ahead and clean the barrel first. So if you don't have a cleaning kit, you can go to Walmart and get one of these. It's like $8, I think. It wasn't too bad. It comes with everything you need. Well, I don't even know what these things are called. They work pretty good though. Brush and your pads. You have to buy your oil and bore cleaner separate, but it's not too much either. But definitely need to make sure you have both of those. So we're going to grab a barrel. I usually take my choke out just so when I'm cleaning it, I can make sure that I get the threads in the barrel. Make sure I get those cleaned out really good. So we're going to go ahead, we're going to grab our rod. I like to start off with a wire brush just in case it's got some gunk or something in there. It just kind of breaks it up, makes it easier to clean. You don't have to. Some people don't. Some people do. Just kind of what you prefer. Just gonna like that. Come back. And I usually kind of spin it around on those threads right there. Just make sure it's clean. And then I go ahead and use a little bore cleaner. So, when you buy a cleaning kit, it'll come with these ones right here, which are fine, nothing wrong with them. I prefer to use these bigger ones, they just seem to work a little better, but it'll work the same, doesn't really matter too much. There like so. And what you can do if you're using these, you can put two of them in. Usually works a little better. I'm using the big ones, but I'm gonna go ahead and put a little one in just because. Never hurts. And that way it also helps keep in memory. We've got two of them. You just kind of fold that back like so. Grab your bore cleaner. Just put a little on each side. Just kind of get your bore cleaner on there. Now, on these Versamaxes, your gas port. The gas is here. I don't know if you can really see it, but there's some ports right there. And those tend to get pretty dirty. there's a lot of guys that say they don't even clean their Versamax until a couple thousand rounds after. So I guess you can do that. Set it runs just fine. Me, personally, I like to shoot it. Or not shoot it, clean it. Well, I do like to shoot it, but I usually clean mine actually almost every time I use it. Just nice gun, they're not cheap. Always better to look at that. That's just after one. In fact, I actually just cleaned this the other day. But never hurts to clean it. Keep everything clean and surrounding good. You definitely want to spend some time cleaning those ports, make sure they're good. You can do, those are dirty, is grab your little mod thing, I don't even know what it's called, this piece, screw it on, and then we'll run it through it just to help, like pretty much soak up any excess blow cleaner that's in there, any excess junk that's left over. And if, you know, if they're still looking pretty dirty, if they don't clean out so well, it shouldn't actually really be a problem. Because like I said, there's a couple guys or so, and they don't even clean theirs until they've shot a couple of thousand rounds. So it's obviously not going to hurt the gun. It never hurts just to make sure. So you can just grab your wire one in there and so, once you get your barrel clean, you can clean the trigger assembly. Usually, unless you've shot a lot through it, it usually doesn't seem to get super dirty like this. Of course, I did just clean mine the other day, but decock it. Just kind of clean in there with your pad. Whatever you're using. Like I said, it's usually not too dirty. And you don't necessarily have to take this out every time you clean it. You can. It's not going to hurt it if you do. And if this is the first time you've cleaned it, or if you haven't even shot yours yet, if you're reading through the user's manual, it suggests that you clean it before you first shoot it. That's just because a lot of times the factory oil and grease that they put on these is really thick and yunky to help protect it while it's being shipped and stuff, not necessarily while it's being fired. So pad, wipe it off, and then just re-oil it with some oil. Make sure you get in here. This, I hate for that to not work. Get around the edge of it. The other thing that you should look into cleaning often is your pistons. Those seem to get pretty dirty. Now, I've never seen one fail, but may as well clean it while you have it out. So just get your cloth. Just run around the lip of this first one right here. You can clean this one. That doesn't really affect it as much, though. Just clean it right there. nice and clean. And usually, after you've been firing it for a while, right here, and right here, where your gas ports are, will get black from your shells, the burnt powder and stuff. That's normal. It just wipes off. You just get some bore cleaner, throw it on a pad. It'll come right off. It's no big deal. Inside here, see if I can show you real quick. The gas ports sit about right here. And so it blows it all in there. And it'll get dark. It'll get black. And you can kind of clean that off. I haven't really had a whole lot of success with cleaning that off. I tried using some contact cleaner, some bore cleaner, some, I don't even know what I've all tried, but no one sees it, doesn't hurt it, it's fine. So, once you get that all cleaned up, go ahead and clean in here, which usually isn't too bad, because you've got everything already out of it. You can just run a claw through it. Yeah, see, it's not too dirty. Get your release. Make sure that's cleaned. Alright, I think we're ready to oil. So, when you're oiling, don't be afraid of using too much. Oil, it's not going to do anything to it. So I usually do this one first. Just get it right along here where it slides. Right here. Definitely in there, like I said, when you were cleaning it. And you just put it in that spot and then just kind of run it like this a couple times. But it still seems to be... Just put it right there. Should be running good. Maybe put a little on the edge. In case. Okay. Run some down the slide. Just to help it function better. And like I said, don't worry about it getting all over. It's not going to hurt anything. Unless you don't want it on your clothes, then wear a different shirt or something. But all along the bottom here and there, pretty much just oil the whole thing. What I found to work best. So just throw it on there, you're probably good to go. Set that down. Right, trigger assembly. Now, when you're putting this back in, if once you've decocked it, it's not going to go together right. So you have to just pull this back and recock it. Pretty simple. A little oil there, there. Pretty much on any of the parts that move, just keep them oiled. All right. Okay. Now the next one that I like to oil is your pistons. Doesn't really say you have to in the user's manual, but I found it just functions better when you do. Just put a little on there, push it in, rotate it, gets around. Same with this one, just like that. Okay. Now let's reassemble. So when you're putting your trigger back in, you want to put in like so. You're going to have to depress your release. That's just not going to slide in all the way. You're going to let off. And it should click into position once. Come on. There we go. Right there. Get your pin. triggers in. This just goes in. Like that. And same with when you're taking your release off. You have to push this down. Goes right in. Okay. For your barrel. Just goes back together like so. Foregrip goes back on. Slides back on. That screws back on. Make sure you get that nice and snug. And you can put your truck in. I guess you don't really have to if you don't plan on going shooting right then, but and always make sure you use your choke wrench. Make sure she's tight. Don't want to make it too tight. But just tight enough that it's not going to slip. Alright. And you are set. Thanks for watching and peace out.